here.
And this is Luke.
And we wanted to talk to you guys today about your why. So guys, this is going to be an incredibly important topic because one thing that a quote that I love to kind of live by when it comes to at least this part is that a man or woman without a vision will perish. And so understanding why you became a coach is going to be incredibly important. And so Luke, why don't you go ahead and start and ask them the questions that they should really start thinking about.
So when it comes to your why and wanting to be successful as a coach, you want to ask yourself, why do you want to have success as a Beachbody coach? So a lot of times we say, oh, I want to do this, or I want to be that, but we don't really have a reason why. So it's good to ask yourself, why do you want to have success and why do you want to be successful as a coach? So to help you understand or to help you really answer that question, you want to think about, do you want personal gain? So what does that mean? That you are able to maybe travel more or just have like more free time to do more things? Is it a family gain? Like you maybe want to spend more time with your family or like travel more with your family or do more for your family? Or is it a financial gain? You just want to make more money. Maybe you want to give more to the poor or whatever the case may be. So it's good to just actually think in those three categories so that you have an idea of what success is like and why you want to have that success for yourself.
And I just want to piggyback off of that because honestly, guys, you really should be thinking really hard about this because one thing I've learned is that when you really think about your why, it should make you cry. It should be something that speaks to your heart because this is a business, like we've been saying, and there is an entrepreneurial roller coaster. There's ups and downs just like any other business. And it can be hard, especially when you're on that kind of down slope. Maybe you're having a bad month or you're having a bad couple weeks or you're having a bad year. I mean, it's possible in business to have a bad year where you're just like, gosh, nothing's working or nothing's coming together. However, if you understand why you want to have success, if it's because, like Luke was saying, it's because you want to be able to spend time with your family, it's because you're tired of missing the best parts of your children's lives because you have to go to a 9-to-5 job, you have to think about why you want to have success. And one tip when it comes to this part is actually to sit down and not only write why you want to have success, but also create what we call a vision board. You know, it's really, you can go on certain platforms like PicMonkey or Canva and really craft out, take photos, you know, go on Pinterest and take photos and really think about so that you can visualize what your success looks like, right? And so creating that vision board to help motivate you that you can either put on your phone, you can put on the backdrop of your computer, you can print it out so that you can always be looking at it so that it can remind you as to why you're doing the hard work. So that's gonna be incredibly important. So asking yourself, again, why do you wanna have success?
And so piggyback riding on what she just said in terms of the vision board, we are all different, we're all unique. So another thing that you want to ask yourself is, you know, what does your success look like? Because everybody can use the word success, but the word success means something very different to me than it meant to Stephanie. So ask yourself that question. What does success look like to you? And I'm probably guarantee you it will be different from the next person or whatever we envision as what success looks like for us. Right?
Exactly, right. Because you know, it's understanding, guys, like for me, I want to be financially free. I want to live location free. I want to be traveling the world every single month. That may not be what you want to do. Maybe success for you is being able to be a stay-at-home mom and be able to go to all of your activities with your family and to be able to create these wonderful memories with your family and not have to go to a 9-to-5. So what I want you to understand is, like Luke's saying, really identify what success looks like to you and also let your coach know what that is, because it's going to be incredibly important so that we can help you, you know, with your business and help navigate you so that you can reach those goals.
And even within the realm of being like financially free, it may look totally different than what she's looking for in this financial freedom. So just know that everyone is unique, everyone is different, so everything will look different from the next person. And on top of that, we would also like to add, how does Beachbody help you get to that level of happiness or success that you're seeking. See how Beachbody can be that vehicle that helps you get mm-hmm. there. That's a good question to ask yourself as well.
Right, because it's like, I always tell people, it's not like one day I woke up and I said, oh, I want to sell challenge packs and I want to sell Shakeology for the rest of my life, right? That's not what I said. However, I want to inspire and motivate millions of women and men to wake up and live their life on purpose and live out their passion. I know that with the help of Beachbody and with the help of our products, it's going to allow me to connect with people so that I can really work towards that mission. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. So asking yourself, you know, understanding that Beachbody can be a vehicle, it can be a stepping stone towards, you know, allowing you to have that financial freedom, allowing you to have that extra money, let's say, so that you can go out and pursue true passions maybe that you're really, really passionate about. And so I just want you guys to kind of really think about that. You know, how can Beachbody serve as that stepping stone? How can it serve as that vehicle to really mm-hmm. kind of think about that? And then also asking you guys, when it comes to kind of thinking about your why, you know, one exercise I want you to do is to close your eyes and visualize what your life will look like when you have reached success. That is incredibly important, because being able to feel those emotions, getting excited, is going to help you, you know, with the excitement, and it's going to help you with the energy to be able to learn the things you're going to have to learn in this business. It's going to help you when you're in those hard times to push through, when you can sit down and really feel and say, okay, this is not for nothing. I am working towards something and I'm going to have success, because, you know, no matter what, I'm going to make sure I keep pushing. And so understanding why you're doing that and closing your eyes and really feeling it is going to help you and really help you identify, you know, and connect to those emotions that may help you through some of those, you know, low times that you may get sometimes in this business, because we're being honest with you, like any business, there's ups and downs. And then asking yourself, you know, why does it matter to you? Why does this success matter to you? Why is it that you want to be able to be at home with your children? Why is it that you want to be debt-free, financially free? Why is it that you want to, you know, be able to provide for your parents and not have them worry? Whatever it is that you want, why? And again, if you ever have trouble and you're like, Stephanie, it's not making me cry enough, just keep asking yourself that question, why? You know, as you're kind of writing it out on paper, why do I want this? You know, why do I want to have success? Why do I want this to work? And as you're kind of thinking that out and just keep asking yourself why, you'll see you'll get deeper and deeper into that. Mm-hmm. And then just understand, guys, that knowing your why will give you a sense of purpose. Like, you know, I know for me, I really, you know, when I became a physician, I kind of was like, well, now what? What's next? I was seeking my passion. I was looking for my purpose. And being a Beachbody coach helped me. It helped to fire up something inside of me that I didn't have with medicine. And so understand that as you become more clear around what your why is, you may feel like you're living a purpose-driven life. And that's what we want for you as your coaches. So something, you know, to really, really think about and something to consider. So I hope that you guys found this helpful. What I'd like for you to do is I'd like for you to write out your why, write out, you know, what it is that you're trying to accomplish, why you want to accomplish that, and make sure that you email it to me or whoever your coach is so that we can review it, we can share in it with you. You know, one thing I love about coaching is being able to read what your dreams are, to be able to read what it is that you want to accomplish and why you want to accomplish it. Mm-hmm. All right, guys. Hope you found this helpful. Bye.